Hello everyone, my name is Philip and welcome to the new Axion weekly update. There is a lot of interesting information in this weekly update, so let's see what is happening in Axion world. So Axion team held multiple AMA sessions this year. A few of them were held in the first week of this year and are not mentioned here, but I will mention only some of them in the last week. So January 10th, Indonesian community AMA session, January 14th, Japanese community AMA session, and January 16th on Sunday, Balkan community AMA session. So very, very engagement, very, very high engagement from Axion team on the start of the year. So let's hope they will also continue this activity level in the coming weeks. There are also constant giveaways on Gleam. So my suggestion, if you want to support Axion on social media, but also earn some additional Axion tokens, is to follow Axion Twitter profile, where you can get all the informations about the future giveaways so you don't miss them. Other than that, Axion Finance opened Axion USDT liquidity pool, which is very, very good for the stabilization of price of Axion on the chart. This is good opportunity for everyone that want to stake on Axion Finance platform, so because they can help to stabilize the price of Axion token, but also to earn more Axion tokens because APR is above 100%, which is amazing. Other than that, Axion participated in another baby bottle competition and managed to win second place, which is amazing. Other than that, they won special award for top social signal project, also from BabySwap project. Because of the second place, they also receive a reward. Axion got rewards from BabySwap, $12,000 in baby tokens and additional $2,000 in USDT tokens. So I'm sure they will use it wisely for the development and community of Axion. So there is a photo which shows the BabySwap bottle winners. And also here is a top social signal project award for Axion. On the other hand, Fumi is lobbying to Japan Congress about blockchain technology. As we all know from the previous weekly updates in Japan, if you inherit cryptocurrencies, you will be taxed 110% after adding various taxes. So this is a big problem in Japan and it should be regulated better. There are also some news about Axiontopi NFT platform. So NFT marketplace will be released in February. From a legal standpoint, we have discussed about this with one of the leading crypto lawyers, so everything is fair and square and we don't have problems with the law. About the company Hardoles Vietnam and Malaysia, Axion is expanding its glass coating business to Southeast Asia. It has the potential to add value to the solar power generation business and has very high expectations. So this is very, very exciting development of Hardoles Vietnam and Malaysia. An overwhelming collaboration with BabySwap is underway. Axion will work on more than just the bottle campaign, so we can expect more collaboration between Axion and BabySwap. We'll see in the near future what happens. And also I will tell you in these weekly updates, in the coming weekly updates, what is happening with this collaboration between Axion and BabySwap. Little bit about the price of Axion token. In comparison to the last week, it went from $1.85 to $1.97, and it is around 6% up, which is always good. Number of holders raised from 2,700 to 2,900. So all around 200 more holders in comparison to the last week. Axie liquidity pool, here comes the interesting part. Most of the projects on Binance Smart Chain is holding their liquidity in BNB only. But here comes the difference because Xfin is using 55% at the moment liquidity of BNB and 45% in USDT, which is very, very smart. Maybe because of a potential bear market, because USDT is holding the price of Xfin and it keeps it more stable. So there is no big fluctuations of the price, and also they are offering a very good APR of above 100% if you stake Xfin USDT liquidity pool on their platform, which you can check on their Xfin Finance platform. About the numbers and the performance of trading and index vaults which are offered on Xfin Finance platform, index vaults on the weekly basis are all in the positive performance, which is very, very good. First place, XFI index 13% up. Second place, Xfin BSC DeFi index 12% up. NFT index on the third place with 5% up. And Japan crypto index on the last place, 4% up. But it's good to be last and still positive. This is good sign. On the other hand, index vaults since foundation are still negative for all of them. XFI index minus 5%, Japan crypto index minus 14%, NFT index minus 58%, and the Xfin BSC DeFi index 80%, which is not good. Not good. Trading vaults on the weekly basis are all of them are positive or neutral, which is also good. Smart contracts on the first place 12% up, BEFF 6% up, Capital Cathedral 3% up, KB 3% up, BGIB 1.5% up, and Mad Money K and SDAA trading vaults are neutral. This means they probably held their portfolio in stable coins because they are careful. They are careful because they are waiting what will happen next in the market before their next move. Since foundation, four of the trading vaults are positive and three of them are negative. BFF 41% up, BGIV 15% up, KB on the third place with 7% up, SDAA 3% up, smart contract 6% down, Mad Money K around 20% down, and Capital Cathedral on the last place trading vaults 39% down. Okay, guys, this is it from me for this weekly update. Stay tuned, follow Xfin on social media. We also have now Instagram, Xfin Finance, so make sure you check this out and follow them on Instagram, and let's see in the next week. Bye.